switch is a pressure switch. This works on the senses to pressure in the line. We went ahead and we've taken off the side cover. It mounts on the discharge side of the pump where there's pressure into a quarter inch pressure line. And when a gun is open and pressure is established into the system, it allows the burner to come on. When you release the gun, then it goes off. Two things that go wrong with these is that, one, if you take off the cover, you can see a switch that's inside there. I've got a spare one here on the side to show. You got three wires that come in because this switch can be normally open, normally closed, either way. Or inside here, there's a piston and a stem and an O-ring. And if the O-ring and the seal goes bad, then water will get inside here. So if you take this cover off and there's water inside here, then that's a pretty good indication that the seal inside here is bad and the entire switch assembly has to be replaced. More often than not, though, what happens is this switch right here goes bad, and we can replace just this switch without having to replace the whole entire body, as long as the seals are good. In order to do that, we just take off the four screws that hold this cover on. It has an O-ring that goes around the outside that seals it, keeps the outside moisture and water from getting inside. And then this switch, you can actually remove with a pair of needle nose pliers once you've removed the power. And you can kind of feel by pressing on the actual switch. If there's a good click, springs back nicely, you can double check it with a continuity checker too to see if it's working. More often than not, if this switch is bad, you won't have that click and it won't want to return back to its original position. Sometimes it'll just go in and stay in or it's just flopping around, and you can kind of feel if the guts of the switch are bad. The switch is wired. I did a schematic. It's already printed on to the side of all of these pressure switches, but it's kind of hard to see with the camera, so I've drawn it out on a pad. Your inlet power comes into the top, which would be on the top side. In this case, you can see the red wire coming in across the top. That's where your power comes in at. The power goes in through the switch, and it's the normally closed position is on the bottom. So if the machine's not running, the power would go into the top and it would come right out the bottom. In this case, you can see it going in the red, it would come out the blue on the bottom. When the gun is opened and it pressures up, what happens is there's a plunger and a spring inside here. The plunger will actually come up and activate that switch. So the plunger will come up just like my finger and it'll engage that switch as long as the gun is open. When the gun is closed, there's a spring that returns that plunger to its original position so that the switch opens up. When that happens and the piston comes up and activates the switch, then the power is transferred over here. And this is the normally open. So when the gun is open and there's pressure and we're calling for burner, the power would come in this switch up in the red, and now it goes out the brown. When the gun is closed and the piston retracts, the switch is deactivated, then the power goes back out the bottom, and in this case that's blue. Pretty simple, fairly easy replacement and repair. Usually you'll find that this switch is bad. Occasionally the spring inside here goes bad, not very often. And the way that you're able to tell that is if this switch feels good, has a nice click to it, has a nice spring back to it. If you reinstall it and you run the machine, and as you open and close the gun, you should be able to see that piston come up and activate the switch, and when you release the gun, the piston goes right back down again. If the spring is broken inside there, what'll happen is the piston will come up and you'll release the gun and the piston either won't retract or it won't retract all the way. It'll stay up inside there. It'll maybe the stroke and the movement of that's real short. In that case, we replace the whole entire pressure switch assembly just to make sure that it's safe. After you reinstall it, the switch rides on a couple of little posts, and the little posts line up with the holes in the switch. So that holds the switch stationary. And then on the back side of the cover, there's a couple of more posts that match with the pressure switch that holds it in place so that as the piston goes back and forth, this switch assembly doesn't move around and wiggle inside there. Pretty simple, pretty reliable, fairly easy to troubleshoot, and that's it.